in South Woodrow Park and the integration of the homeless people that was already here before they moved in. You know, I came to speak out for populations of the world, worldwide problem going on with poverty, and the homeless people came in and started volunteering. So that should, because I'm an advocate for the homeless too, that should help people who think homeless are bad people and think these are human beings, because they are here, out here supporting the cause. You know, they had a few problems as communication problems, which I feel a policy should have been set up by now to explain something, what the separation is between the homelessness and as far as the whole occupied Atlanta is doing a good job, and all across the world. It's been done balanced here in Atlanta, and which was heard earlier that he has some incidents in New York and Chicago.
Yeah.
And so occupied Atlanta is, he should be an example to other movements too, because it is nonviolent, and if we practice nonviolence, that's a copy, yes, what Martin Luther King demonstrated in 1960.
Now, you said you were the advocate for the homeless, right?
Yes,
and your name?
My name is Michael Brockman.
Okay.
I first started advocating for the homeless in Arlington, Virginia. I graduated from Allen County Neighborhood College Program, which we just did as a community leader. And I was on a 10-year plan to task force the homeless. Now I'm down here, and just coming down here to live there, get a job, you know, but I see there's a lot of discrimination towards the homeless here. Like they got signs posted, don't give manhandlers money and give me, you know, the Supreme Court said 1993 is freedom of speech. So they criminalize the homeless right now.
Okay, so what you're saying is the panhandling law here in Atlanta is unconstitutional.
Yes, it is. Very much so. See, the Constitution, the Supreme Court said, if you stand on public property asking people to change, then that's human speech. Now, if you approach them, you know, in an intimidating manner, and they tell you no, and you keep after them, and try to force them, or just nag them until they get, like, here, just get taken. And that's aggression. That's illegal. But if you just stand and ask people one time they walk by, can they help you? That's legal. But you can be arrested for just doing that, because it's so, the city has put false propaganda out, or they didn't correct the propaganda, put it out there, and say an aggressive man, let the public know. You know, so now that when you see a panhandler, he's automatically doing something wrong. And then they make complaints to the police. Police don't fully understand the law themselves, or they go along with the population, which is peer pressure. They follow the peer pressure. If the populace say, this is bad, then definitely it's bad, we're going to arrest you for it. But you can't arrest somebody for something that they already have a right. Let them judge by the highest court of the land. They got that right. They can't arrest them for that. If you live, thousands of people hate what you do. And that's still not the constitutional right. And if thousands of people who hate them for what they're doing, should read the Constitution. You know, they don't want a problem. Here's a person exercising the right. And another thing in Atlanta is like Odyssey 3. It's a homeless program, it's a nonprofit organization that helps homeless if you stay in a shelter. You know, they say, I went to them with a letter saying, I went to homeless verification from the church. And they said they couldn't help me because I wasn't staying in the shelter. So, because they got this pathway program here where all the communications, it's a computerized system where all the agencies can look up and see if somebody using the programs. I understand that, right? But if you're not in this program, then they won't send you, they won't respect you. Because if you like trying to keep the pathway, so pathway paid as good as you. And the more people, the more they get paid and everything else. So they try to keep it like a union. When it should be like, well, you are getting help. You know? And when I see address and a telephone for employment. They denied me that because I wasn't staying in the shelter. Though they looked up the very same halfway program, I'm saying that I was taking showers at the Gateway City shelter here every morning. I took showers. So, and then they can see that I have been using the services for like the last 6 months.
Wasn't that, this is the Odyssey program?
Odyssey 3.
Odyssey 3. And who is what department is that in? Is that a city of Decatur?
No, it's in Atlanta. It's on Decatur Street.
Okay.
And
so it's a government program.
Yes, it's funded by city and some federal funds.
Okay.
You know, and I
And they're denying you unless you live in a shelter.
Right.
So they're only helping the homeless that live in shelters.
Not the people in the street. That's what it's supposed to be. Homeless is people in the street.
Mm-hmm.
Also. So
how difficult is it to get into a shelter?
No, just a guy to show up. They're pretty much down the street.
I mean, do you have to be there like at a certain time?
Well, yes, yeah. Well, I think P-Stream Pine, I think that's called that's they check in at 7.
Mm-hmm.
Come after 7, well, you know, 7, I come after that time at 8 p.m.
Yeah, I mean, are there limits as to how many people can be there per night?
Well, I don't actually know, but I know both.
Have you ever been turned away yet? Let me ask you that.
No, I haven't.
Okay.
Because I show up at the times that they do check.
So then what you're saying is, it sounds like you're saying that the Odyssey program, which says that you should have a residence, and you could have a residence at one of these shelters, why don't
yes.
you?
Oh, well.
What's the problem there?
Mainly, I didn't stay at these streams time because of the atmosphere around the place. I want to get into it.
Yeah, I've been to a few homeless shops. I've been around a few of them, and I know sometimes it can be drugs and some crazies and,
yeah.
and some thugs, and I can understand that you may not want to.
So I was, Atlanta University, they didn't do it first, but they started doing it, taking out. ID and social security card. Well, I had lost that, which caused me to, I couldn't get in. So I had, you're right, I had been denied to get in, even though they knew me.
Mm-hmm.
So I was sitting behind this church, but I was taking a shower. It was summertime.
I got you. So in other words, you have to have state ID
and
social security card. And a social security card?
And a social security card.
State ID is not enough.
No.
You have to have both in order to get into the shelter.
Right.
And if you don't, then you can't come in.
Right.
That's wow.
And that's what, you know, so I was like...
Is that like for identification purposes?
Yeah, and government funding, because they get money for everybody in the states.
Okay.
You know, and that's how they support themselves. Plus, they got private donations from the people on the streets and stuff to support them.
Mm-hmm.
And, what are we talking about? Odyssey 3?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but let me make a statement. When I came to Atlanta, I came to Atlanta, got a job, give me a place, and I'm still ever since February. This is October. Now, and I'm still in the street because the city has set up a trap. All these services are a trap. Now, one thing I want to start saying is that not all, they got shelter. But they got some, they got grown people running. Because you don't have to,
can you explain that?
You don't have to bring a food in a shelter to get put out. Say something that they don't like, and they'll put you out. Just throw you out. And if you're working on something, like in a job or have a job, now they throw you out because you said something they don't like.
Give me an example.
You know, Gateway. When I was first checked in the Gateway, you say they got a Project Connect. There was a man that was there, he stayed there 105 days. I think he was like 100, he had 91 days. Had a job, saving money, got the help. But they put him out for not needing the details. Threw him out. All his belongings and everything else, not needing the details. And I thought that was crazy because when whole purpose of them being there for the homeless. If you think that doing a detail is that important, you need to hire people to come in and clean the building. But you got residents there cleaning the building. You know? And the reason he missed is because he was working.
Gotcha. Yeah. Give me an example of somebody been thrown out because he just said something they didn't like.
Oh, this is, I've seen it a thousand times. They come in, they make an announcement. Somebody makes a comment on it, and you can get put out. Because, you know, you do have a right to freeze.
Oh, you talking about somebody just kind of like snickering or something, or just making a joke or a wisecrack?
Yes.
And you can get thrown out because of the wisecrack, is what you're saying.
Right.
That's messed up.
Even at the Gateway program, they let you have to take showers, but they shut the showers down. It's a little thing. They're like, they bust in the store. But where the people who set their chairs at for the showers, that chair's not even good in the front of the store, and they bust it. But they didn't use that for excuses. So on Saturdays, they got people standing outside, looking Monday through Friday, Saturday and Sunday. You come in the city, they said, and on Saturday and Sunday, you got to stand out in a line outside the building. You know, to get in to take a shot.
Well, tell me something. How exactly do you think Occupy Bohannon is helping the homeless situation? Or are they?
Well, I think the homeless is helping Occupy Bohannon.
Oh, okay.
Because there's some volunteers that are homeless.
Okay.
And, and they out here in numbers. You know, and that's why Occupy Bohannon need numbers to help support. So it's a local thing. Local people, businesses are bringing in food because they're out here.
I got one last question for you. I see a lot of black folks here in Atlanta that are homeless, have been for a while. Like I said, I've lived here for 19 years. And it seems to me that the face of the movement that I tend to see are, you know, for the most part, really white. Is there a problem that there's not enough black participation within the Occupy Atlanta movement itself?
Homeless people who have been homeless for a long period of time, they just give it up. They don't fight for it no more. Like I said, it's a trap. When you try to get a job, like I had got a job, we got in the city shelter. That's a 90-day commission. But I got in without doing the paperwork. Then they work for me now to come in early themselves to do paperwork. Because I was working from 9 to 6, I had to leave before they got in, so they came in early. When I did put out people in the center, I couldn't stay there because I had to make $120 a week. You know, and see, the Project Connect paid 100% of the rent for the first month, 80% the second month, 30% the third month. And so because they do this, they have all these things you got to do. Gratitude. You have to give one check before moving to the hotel. You know, I was a duck.
Right. And in other words, what you're saying is commission jobs don't qualify.
No.
That's not enough. Okay.
So you run into this type of thing, like trying to get a job. No one in these downtown businesses has these black cards now. And then they know who you are. Especially if you put the shelter as an address. They're not going to hire you. So you got to leave outside this area to get a job. You know, nobody will give you money for a bus ticket to go out there and look for a job. And that's crazy because as soon as you go out there and get a job, you become a taxpayer. So they don't want you to be a taxpayer. They just want to keep you as trapped so the police can arrest you and the city can make money from the government by locking you up.
Okay, I tell you what. This is going to be at the end. I just want you to tell me anything else that you would want the rest of the world to know. But like I said, I'm going to put this up on my YouTube channel. So just tell me anything else that you think that the folks need to know.
That homeless are human beings. Don't listen to what the media is putting out there about them being drug addicts, alcoholics, and stuff like that. Because they wasn't like that. And that was before people got them to work. These human beings. You need to look at them as individuals, not as a whole. Don't judge one by the actions of others. least one homeless person.
Thanks, man. I appreciate you.